Hey there, welcome back. I'm Brandon with Be Aircooled, and you are in part two of our Lancia Delta Integrale Evo 2 fuel pressure system shakedown. As mentioned in part one, how to connect up and direct run your fuel pump without having to turn your ignition switch, and how to give the fuel pressure regulator a thorough shakedown. Once you complete step one for your car, you move on to step two here to continue troubleshooting the fuel pressure system. Again, just a recap, the issue that we've been having with this particular car is a really, really rough idle. It hunts for idle, it stumbles and it falls. The fuel injection light is also on the dash. However, with these Italian cars in general, but also with the Lancias, you can't just jump to conclusions. There's a lot of different stages. So I like to go process by process. That's also the same way we deal with our Porsches and the same way we deal with our little Volkswagens here. So what we're going to do right now is we're going to put together a quick test of the fuel pump itself. Fuel pump pressure on the Lancia Delta Integrales should run about 4.5 bar on the weak side and up to 7 bar on the high side. So if you're between those ranges, then you're healthy with your fuel pump. If you're below those ranges, then you're suboptimal. You should replace the fuel pump, and that's probably the source of your problem the entire time. So what we're going to do is we're going to run a real quick fuel pump test. We've got our fuel pressure gauge connected up. This one does PSI, but we just convert it to bar on our own. And we also have our jumper relay in place. If you check out the first episode, we'll show you how to install the jumper relay and how we've gone ahead and done that, what pins to connect to. So what we're going to do now is I'll kind of detail again, give a quick brush up the way that we've teed into the fuel line system. Off the bottom of the fuel pressure rail, top goes to the regulator, fuel pressure regulator, bottom of the fuel pressure rail, connect up there. If you have a compression fitting, use the compression fitting. We didn't have one in our fuel line kit. Snap-on didn't provide me one. Those guys, am I right? And so we decided to put a seal-tight big hose over it and clamp it down. So we were able to get away with that. And we come up into our system here. So this is coming right off of the fuel rail, right? And this T-in we're going to use in our next video, but we've just got it blocked off for right now. We've got our ball valve here. And then on this side, we've got our gauge teed in. And then this side is going back, or going forward rather, the supply line from the fuel filter down here. So our fuel filter supply line. So that would normally supply direct fuel to the rail. Then fuel comes through the rail, hits all of your injectors, goes to the fuel pressure regulator, back out the bottom of the pressure regulator when it hits 3 bar in the 16-valve Evo 2 car. Hit 3 bar, valve in the regulator opens, sends you back to the tank, and that's how the fuel pressure system works. So what we're going to do right now is we're going to run our fuel pump. We're going to cut fuel pressure at the ball valve here, and that'll leave us with just pressure on the gauge side, and we're going to cut our fuel pump right away so that we don't back it up, we don't damage it or overheat it in any way. And we'll get a reading on our gauge, and it should be somewhere in our 4.5 to 7 bar range. So I'm expecting to probably hit close to the 100 PSI side of things, and that'll tell us if our fuel pump is healthy and strong. So again, you only do this for a couple of seconds. Try and keep some light on the gauge here, if I can. I might not be able to. Is it readable that way?
Yeah, we're good.
Okay. So as long as you guys can see that, we're good. So I'm gonna run the fuel pump first, so it's just gonna be going through the system by turning my switch on. Then next stage is I'm gonna be cutting fuel off from the rail itself, and that'll just back everything up at the gauge. All right, so here we go. We're gonna do this pretty quick. So fuel pump running, there's our fuel pressure at the regulator. We're cut off, oh yeah. And then we come right back. So you can see we peaked out at over 100 PSI there. That probably just has to do with the sensitivity of my gauge and the flow rate. I don't wait for it to stabilize or back off. I'm sure if I let it just bounce against the gauge, the needle would come back a little bit. But that tells me that we're in the good range with our fuel pump, clearly. We've also troubleshot this system a little bit in advance and tested the regulator as we did in the first part of our video series. So we kind of knew that we were already working with solid fuel pressure. So our next step and our next video is going to be the injection leak down test. We'll show you how to go through the process of troubleshooting your fuel injectors. And that is going to be a fun one. So stay tuned.